Hello everyone, and welcome back to Kerbal Space Program. This is Skybird Designs episode 16. And today we're starting off with Gun Mark 1 by Extreme Mining. Now we have a lot to talk about in this video, a lot. In fact, this is a re-uploaded version of the previous version of this video. So we'll get into that in a moment. Now this design is called Gun Mark 1 by Extreme Mining. It has a bullet that does not fire properly. And the whole gun just falls down. it's an interesting design that was submitted to me. That's why I wanted to feature it. I like the concept. It's a gun, but it doesn't work at all. Like, the bullet just falls down. Bullet's not meant to fall down. What's going on? Anyway, that's just a hilarious design. Try it out if you want. It's fun. Anyway, so this one here is... I think it's called Tank. I don't think it has a specific name to it other than Tank from what I've seen. Probably does have a name to it, like Awesome Tank or something. This is by Vales3712, who was a well-known YouTuber around the KSP community. Well, at least I know about him. I don't know about you guys. But I do talk to him every now and then, so he's pretty well-known to me. Anyway, so he submitted this design because he's saying that there are a few problems with the missiles. So it turns out that not all the missiles are actually going straight, and he was wondering how to fix that. He had a few issues with people complaining about the design because of that issue or something like that. If some of you want to know as well, he's left a bit of advice here. Number 5 on your keyboard is for the ladder, and number 0 is for the back antennas, just for looks really. So this tank is fun to fly around with. Drive around with, yeah. I was just driving it and I just liked crashing it. It can handle so much brute force. A crash, it will survive. The missiles may not survive, but the whole thing will survive in general. Why? Because of those panels. Those panels can handle what? An impact tolerance of 80 meters per second. That is correct. And that's why they don't break. Unless the joints break, but everything else is perfectly fine. And if you're wondering what those explosions are, that is those missiles. Those missiles are going bang, bang, bang. So for this design, I did remake the missiles, and I added like a big, huge missile. Is it really necessary? Well, let me explain the problem with some of these missiles. Now, in the early staging, the missiles do go straight, such as this one that you're seeing right now. But in the later staging, the missiles placed do not go straight. Why? From what I can tell, this is just me being stupid here, actually. I tested this out before. The exact same thing happened. So, the thing that I understand or recognized is that the missiles that were going straight are the ones that have separatrons on the top and bottom. The missiles that do not go straight, as in like they fall down, they have missiles, the separatrons on the left and right, on both sides of the missile itself. I think that's why, you know, top and bottom works, sides does not work. So I guess, you know, if you replace everything with the top and bottom, top of missiles, then everything should be fine with going straight. I could tell you did things specifically to look good, but not as functional. But it turns out that we're pretty lucky here. I still had the houses left over from the iRobot iRobot video we made back then with like hundreds of missiles shooting at these houses. So we still had these houses, luckily. And still in perfect condition, so I figured, why not just shoot at them? I mean, we have a tank, right? And I know tanks don't have, like, these types of missiles. I know that. It's just, it's KSP, right? You can do whatever you want. That's the freedom with this game. It's cool. But let me talk to you about the reason why this video has been re-uploaded. Now, it turns out a subscriber, who goes by the name of, if he is indeed a subscriber, his name is Dr. J10343, if that's correct. Correct me if I'm wrong, sir. It turns out that he stole a craft from a YouTuber, an ex-YouTuber, who goes by the name of G4Virus. Now, I'm completely against any stolen crafts. I do not like that. It's someone's time and effort to make something. This craft, this tank, is someone's time and effort. If I stole this, someone would be mad. Vaos would be mad. That's why you gain permission from that person in order to use their craft. That's the best way to do it. Well, if you're going to feature someone's craft in a video or mention them somewhere, or mention the craft, at least mention that person's name, the actual original creator. Now, if you've modified the design, then still mention the original creator, but say, hey, look, I've modified this design. That's the right thing to do. Now, the wrong thing to do, Doctor, I'm just gonna call him Doctor for now, he stole the craft. He didn't tell me it was stolen. Obviously, he's not gonna tell me, right? Why would he tell me? And he stole it. He submitted it to me. I used it in a video, a feature that turns out I didn't. I got quite a bit of bad feedback from people telling me, this is stolen, or this is not. Well, they didn't really say it was stolen. They said it was by G4 Virus, not this Doctor guy, which they were correct. And the thing is, the reason why, this is what Doctor said. He said Doctor is no longer certified. I took away his certifications. No, that's just me being silly. But this tank, man, this tank is awesome. No, seriously, Doctor, he. The reason why he submitted this design, this is what he was saying. I should have screenshot it, but he said that he made a bet with a buddy on whether or not I actually do research on the designs that's submitted to me. Now, there are a couple things. Firstly, there's an agreement in the description of every most of the videos, the latest videos, saying that, hey, look, no stolen crafts. That's what it says. I think it says it in those exact words. No stolen crafts, and that kind of rule was broken. Obviously, rules get broken, so that was broken. But what's more importantly, Doctor didn't tell me it was stolen. I mentioned that again. It's just I wasn't happy with the fact that it was stolen. Now, like, how could I find out if this craft was stolen or not? Now, how can I do it? Now, let's just say I steal a design, and this design is called the Fabulous Tank. Let's just say I steal a design called that. Now, I've never stolen a design, but let's just say that I did. And it's called Fabulous Tank. I found out on the Google KSP forums, right? I can easily get that design and rename it. I really can. In fact, I can redesign it. That's how simple things are. That's why I don't do my research. Anyone with the brains can easily remake a design, do anything like that. That's why I don't do my research on these designs that submitted to me. And I had faith in, obviously, I did know that eventually someone was going to steal a craft. I knew it. But, I guess I didn't really tell you guys off about it. Anyway, bad boy, Doctor. Bad boy. Punishment for you. This missile was at you. Bang. But, yeah, seriously. Anyway, let me talk about G4 Virus. So, there's an ex-YouTuber. Turns out that he deleted his channel because of the Google Plus implementation. But before that, this missile. I'm fairly sure this missile hit. I think it just went straight through the house. I don't know. If you want to replay that and confirm with me what the hell happened with that missile, because I'm fairly sure it hit. But it said, well, at least it went through the house. That's probably what it did. Anyway, G4 Virus, he deleted his channel because of the Google Plus implementation. He doesn't like it, doesn't agree with it. You know what? Let's talk about something. How bad has Google Plus really been? Really? Google Plus, YouTube, they enforce Google Plus upon us. Okay, yeah, I agree. And I don't like it. But the fact that they're forcing stuff onto us that we don't want, but they did it anyway. Why not? They have the power, they have the control. They can do whatever the hell they want. As long as they're making money, they're happy. Now, it's not like, just because you quit YouTube doesn't mean everyone else is going to quit YouTube just to prevent Google Plus from, being implemented. It's still going to be implemented. We still have thousands of people that depend upon YouTube as an income, which isn't really something people should depend on. But anyway, as a part-time job, it's fine. I treat this as a part-time job, but as a full-time job, it should not be treated like that. This is the internet. Money made on the internet does not last long. Oh, but prepare for this awesome missile on the tank. This tank is gonna bang. Yeah, bang. That's awesome. Anyway, it's sad G4 Virus did delete his account. I would have liked to maybe speak to him like I speak to others on this YouTube website. But anyway, oh well. Goodbye. But apparently, he did have some really good designs, and they are on the KSP forum. So I'm gonna look up G4 Virus, and you might find some interesting things. Anyway, so back to this design. I did modify this design. You can see with the missiles, big ass missile as well. I will include everything, this modified version, in the download link as well. So Vales, try it out, tell me what you think. But more importantly, thanks for the submissions from both Extreme Gaming and Vales. 3712, forget the numbers. And yeah, links in description. So again, hope you enjoyed, and see you next time. Take care. Bye.